Listen to this sound. Oddly enough, it's likely that this is an iconic sound you're familiar with, but it's equally likely that you never really encounter it in your daily modern life anymore. This sound is Morse code, and it was a critical piece of the puzzle necessary to the early telegraph that permanently transformed how people communicate forever. Us humans are strange animals. We have this insatiable drive to innovate technology, just so that we can further innovate the most recent innovated technologies. Rocks turn into hammers, and hammers turn into 750-ton colossal steam hammers capable of delivering a blow of up to 100 tons. Technological innovation itself is quite evident, but what's more curious is the reason why we innovate. Sometimes things are created to make us happy, sometimes it's driven out of competition to create more value than a rival business. But in today's case of Samuel Morse's key modernizations of the telegraph, innovation can sometimes be sparked by something else, the former seed of tragedy. Before Morse gained notoriety as an inventor, he was a modest painter. While he was quite the talented artist, he faced the same struggle that even artists today still have to face. It was difficult for him to bring in a reliable income through his art. However, in February 1825, things looked like they were turning around for Morse. He was commissioned by the city of New York to paint Marquis de Lafayette. While he was traveling, his wife Lucretia wrote to him from their home back in New Haven, Connecticut. She wrote, "We must begin to feel proud of your acquaintance. I think now that we can indulge a rational hope that the time is not very far distant when you can be happy in the bosom of your much-loved family." Samuel and Lucretia were expecting their third child at the time, and this work for him in New York was a promising sign that things were beginning to look up for Samuel's ability to provide for his family through his work. He wrote back in a brief letter, "I long to hear from you." The unfortunate reality, however, would be Samuel Morse's longing to hear from his wife would never come to fruition. Many days later, Samuel had never received a response from his wife until a letter was finally delivered to him from his father, saying, "My heart is in pain and deeply sorrowful, while I announce to you the sudden and unexpected death of your dear and deservedly loved wife." From a heart attack while recovering from childbirth, Lucretia had died before having the opportunity to respond to Samuel's letter. After receiving word from his father, he rushed back to his family, but enough time had passed from the time the letter reached his hands that his wife had already been buried by the time that he arrived. Up until this point in his life, Samuel had been plagued by disappointments in his work, and it was through this tragedy that the seed for his future innovation had been planted. This time, the pain and disappointment he experienced was the direct cause of slow and ineffective long-distance communication. It would be 7 years until the pieces of the puzzle would start to fall into place and cultivate the deeply planted seed that drove Morse to see a better way to come into existence. Because at that time, recent developments in electromagnetism showed promise that information could be sent through wires at speeds never before imaginable. While returning by ship from Europe in 1832, Morse encountered a man named Charles Thomas Jackson from Boston, a man well educated in the modern developments of electromagnetism. It's said that he had overheard a conversation discussing the new potentials of sending messages electrically through wires. This is where Samuel Morse began his transformation from painter to inventor. Morse set aside his former passions of painting and began to ruthlessly focus his efforts on his new idea of the single-wire telegraph. And in 1840, his patent for improvements in the mode of communicating information by signals by the application of electromagnetism was granted by the United States Patent Office, and with it also came the infamous system of dots and dashes known throughout the world as Morse code, which is still the standard for rhythmic data transmission to this day. Regardless of the legal controversies of who was first and who should be credited with the invention of a new technology, which rightfully shroud most every new innovation where many people are inputting new developments and competing to be in the front of any new technology, I want to keep the focus on one simple theme for this video. We as humans have the unique ability to create, transform, and destroy. And throughout our lives, we encounter an entire spectrum from moments of extreme joy to moments of crushing tragedy. And it's these moments that shape the future of our lives. It gives us the opportunity to choose between creation, transformation, or destruction. Samuel Morse's story can serve as a reminder to us that even through tragedy, the seed planted from a negative experience can be used as motivation to bring positive change into the world. Morse would have never imagined that a standardization and improvements to data transmission through wire would serve as the bedrock in technological innovation that would not only lead to the telephone, but would pave the path all the way to you watching this video right now on the modern internet. Innovation starts with something new every day, And here at Common Knowledge, I create videos on a whole range of interesting topics from technology to psychology to the odd things that seem simple on the surface until you start to dig a little deeper. It's a new channel, so if you like the content, I would be absolutely excited for you to subscribe and comment and be a part of this growing community. We've nearly doubled our subscribers in the past few months, so I want to give a huge thank you to everyone who's here supporting the work. And as always, obliterate that like button for the YouTube algorithm.